السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهديه الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Still in Surah Al-An'am, this beautiful surah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it was said to be that it was revealed all at once, not verses after verses. And the reason for that is that the subject of the surah is only one subject, and that is the tawheed, the best subject ever, which is the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in worship. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the messengers of Allah, all of them, with that message, the message of the tawheed, the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, calling people to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the books. And the final book, the Quran, the final message to mankind, to worship none but the creator of the heavens and the earth alone. And for really for the human beings to have this belief in them, it is sufficient for them to have the message from a messenger of Allah to call them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. He would mention so many of the evidences of the tawheed. The entire Quran is about the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many, many evidences that are mentioned so that nobody will have any doubt whatsoever if they open their hearts to the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Quran. If sincerely, truthfully, people recite the Quran and reflect upon the meanings of the Quran without any prejudice, without any arrogance, without any hatred or envy or anything of that evil and sick diseases in the heart, the person would see clearly the purity of the message. A person would see how perfect is the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what we see in the surah, that's what we see in the entire Quran. We reached verse number 17 in Surah Al-An'am, and we will try inshallah ta'ala to go through the verses from 17 to 21, from verse number 17 in Surah Al-An'am to verse number 21, more of the evidences of the tawheed, of the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the verses that talks about the power of Allah, proving that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship, and also proving that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger of Allah. Verse number 17, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍّ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Which means, and if Allah should touch you with adversity, there is no remover of it except Him. And if He touches you with good, then He is over all things competent. وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍّ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّهُ. That if any dur is harm, any adversity, whether it's big or small, anything that you would hate to happen to you, and the one that is being addressed by this is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and every single human being, believers and disbelievers, and everyone that would recite the Quran, that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يَمْسَسْكَ بِضُرٍ يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍ, that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala touches you with any adversity. And the word yamsask is far more general than to be afflicted or to have the harm, you know, happens to you. It's something that shows the slightest harm, whether it's very small, very light, or whether it's very major and big, everything is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِيَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍ. So it includes all kinds of harms, whether it's small or big. فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّهُ. No one will be able to remove it except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ. There is no removing to it whatsoever. No one is to remove it. No remover to the harm that afflicted you, that touched you, إِلَّهُ, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we heard many times in the verses before, that this is this type of structure of the sentence is the most exclusive in meanings. It's like La ilaha illallah. It's the most exclusive meaning when it comes to the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which means there is no one worthy of worship except Allah. There's nothing more exclusive than this. It's more exclusive than saying the only one worthy of worship is Allah. No, more exclusive is when you say there's no one worthy of worship except Allah. Negation in the context of an exception. So here the same thing, فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّهُ. There is no remover whatsoever to the harm that afflicted you or touched you, إِلَّهُ, except him, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the other side, وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. And if he touches you with good, then he is over all things competent. وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ بِخَيْرٍ. The same thing, any khayr, any good, whether it's big or small, the slightest, the smallest good and the biggest good, touches you. Doesn't have to be that you're immersed in it. Anything whatsoever of goodness that happens to a person, who's the one that is able to do all things? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. That he is competent, he's able to do all things. As you see, the verse has part of it which is belief, of course, because this is what we should believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he's the creator of the heavens and earth, and he's the one that created us, and he created everything else. So that means good and evil, everything is in the control and the ownership of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and everything happens by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the belief is there, and also the outcome of this and the benefit of such a belief is basically the joy of this life. The real joyful people on the face of earth are the believers, because they are content. They have these beautiful beliefs in their hearts. They rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one in control of all things, if harm afflicts you, touches you, who's the one that would remove it from you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So why panic? Why rely on other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? No one can remove any harm from you except by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't fear the human beings. Don't fear anything. Don't fear anyone except the one that created you. Turn to him alone subhanahu wa ta'ala and worship him and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask him, pray to him, supplicate to him. He's the one that saved those who are in need of him, as it's mentioned in the Quran, in many verses of the Quran. And he is the only one that is able to bring any benefit to you, which is basically, again, the essence of the tawheed, to rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The highest level of the tawheed is the tawakkul, to rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your heart, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we hear, this is some of his attributes. وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍّ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. It brings peace to the heart. It brings really the real freedom for the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they don't rely on anyone except by the creator of the heavens and the earth. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says after that in verse number 18, وَهُوَ الْقَاهِرُ فَوْقَ عِبَادِهِ وَهُوَ الْحَكِيمُ الْخَبِيرُ, which means, and he is the subjugator over his servants, and he is the wise, the acquainted with all. Again, some of the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ الْقَاهِرُ فَوْقَ عِبَادِهِ. Al-Qahir is one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As you see, the meaning, the subjugator, the one that is overpowers any of his creation, that he has the authority and he has the power. He has the authority over his creation, and he is the one that can subjugate them to do whatever he wills subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he's above all. He's the one that created them, and he is over his servants. He's over his creation, over his throne subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he's over them with his power and with his knowledge and so on. وَهُوَ الْحَكِيمُ الْخَبِيرُ, and he is the most wise, the all acquainted of everything that the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are in and doing and so on. The meaning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being الْقَاهِرُ فَوْقَ عِبَادِهِ, that means nobody can overpower Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, overpower the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The believers, when they see, for example, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow for the disbelievers, for those who are evil, to commit their evil, and in sometimes they would oppress the believers, and they would spread so much evil on the face of earth, and it might seem to those who are foolish and those who are ignorant that these people of evil characters, that they have nobody can stop them whatsoever. that they have so much power that they can basically do whatever they want. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-qahiru fawqa ibadi. He's the subjugator over his servants. And part of that meaning is that these disbelievers, these evildoers, they don't do whatever they do except from the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that subjugated them to do it and to be part of the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to test the believers. And this is a very important concept. Who's the one that sent a tyrant or an evil person to spread corruption on the face of earth? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to punish him more, and for the believers to be tested, and for the great qualities of the believers to be there as far as patience and struggle for the sake of Allah and the like of these acts of worship. Yes, a person, he's responsible for his actions, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the qahiru fawqa ibadi. That means nobody can do anything without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, again, it is directing the hearts of the believers not to worry too much about what other human beings are doing, but rather to witness the actions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to see that everything is by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so to know that they have a purpose on the face of earth, and that is to worship the creator of the heavens and the earth. And if he wills subhanahu wa ta'ala, he can destroy all of the ones that are evildoers and so on, but there's a wisdom behind it, and that is to have the struggle between the truth and the falsehood for the purpose of this life to be achieved, for great meanings of the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by the people of the truth, and for the truthful ones, and for those who are not on the truth and those who are evildoers, for them to be clearly separated so that the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is served. That's why it says, وَهُوَ الْحَكِيمُ الْخَبِيرُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most wise. Why the qahr or the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it does not seem sometimes to be over the disbelievers and destroying them all at once? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most wise. And once they die, which is part of the meaning of what it means to be al-qahiru fawqa ibadi, nobody can push away death from his own self, let alone from someone else. No one can push away sickness if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will for it to happen. And he mentioned that, and he said that subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah An-Nisa, أَيْنَمَا تَكُونُوا يُدَرِكُمُ الْمَوْتُ وَلَوْ كُنْتُمْ فِي بُرُوجٍ مُشَيَّدَةٍ. That no matter where you are, death will come to you, even if you are in fortified places and towers and so on, death will come to you. What happened to the most powerful people on the face of earth before? They all passed away and they returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they would see the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is part of the power of Allah, that they cannot, even with all of the power that they have, they cannot push away old age from them, for example, and the signs of being old. They get old and they die and they are buried, so they're not that powerful. They cannot really control the universe, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above all, and He is al-khabir, the well-acquainted of who deserve what, and what the human beings are doing, and what is their rewards and punishments and so on. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala with more of these verses in Surah Al-An'am right after the break, so stay with us
inshallah.
Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Welcome back, and still with verses number 17 to 21 from Surah Al-An'am, this blessed surah that talks about the tawheed, the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how important it is to have these verses of the Quran purifying our hearts. We are in need constantly to be reminded of these meanings, because the hearts get polluted whenever we deal with one another. When people read the news, for example, when they are in state of ghafla, state of forgetfulness, you know, that's why the Quran purify the hearts, to remind them, to remind us constantly that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above all, that we have a purpose to fulfill on the face of earth, and that is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone with all different types of acts of worship till the moment of death, and one of which is to see how the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that nobody can remove away harm from you if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't will for that to happen. Nobody can bring any benefit to you unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will for that to happen. He's the one that is able to do all things, and He is the subjugator over His creation. Nobody can really have a say or have power whatsoever except by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to see things in the right perspective. So when the believers, they see others are committing evil or atrocities or spreading corruption on the face of earth, they should remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the subjugator over His creation. And they are basically being dragged to do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordained for them to do, for the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be served against them, and for the believers to gain the great rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their patience and seeking rewards and so on. And at the end, everybody shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody, no matter how powerful they are, they cannot even push away death from them. This is the inevitable thing that they have to all return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are going to be judged by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most just, and He's the most wise, subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa huwa al-hakim al-khabir. And we said, the more we reflect upon this, the more we would see everything around us with the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and with the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that whatever things happen, happen by the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He is al-khabir. Now, al-khabir has the meaning of the most knowledgeable, but more in a subtle way, in the things that are hidden. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the all-knower, whether something that is very clear or something that is hidden, and hidden from the human beings, and we do not really know everything. We might think that we know what is best for us or what should be done, or sometimes we would suggest even that the world should look like this or like that, as if a person is suggesting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what is the best decree to happen. This is such an evil thing. Everything is by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So He is Al-Khabir. He is the one that is well acquainted of who deserves what and what should be decreed in what time and what place, for again the best of how a person should live his life, and that is to fulfill the purpose of one's life, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Then after that, the next verse talks about that the proof again and the evidences for this message, for the deen of Allah, for the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and following the way of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Verse number 19, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ أَيُّ شَيْءٍ أَكْبَرُ شَهَادَةٌ قُلِ اللَّهِ شَهِيدٌ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكُمْ وَأُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنُ لِأُنذِرَكُمْ بِهِ وَمَنْ بَلَغْ أَإِنَّكُمْ لَتَشْهَدُونَ أَنَّ مَعَ اللَّهِ آلِهَةً أُخْرَى قُلْ لَا أَشْهَدْ قُلْ إِنَّمَا هُوَ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ وَإِنَّنِي بَرِيءٌ مِمَّا تُشْرِكُونَ. Which roughly means, say, what thing is greatest in testimony? Say, Allah is witness between me and you. And this Quran was revealed to me that I may warn you thereby and whomever it reaches. Do you truly testify that with Allah there are other deities? Say, I would not testify with you. Say, indeed, He is but one God, and indeed I am free of what you associate with Him. So this verse that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قُلْ أَيُّ شَيْءٍ أَكْبَرُ شَهَادَةً. Say, what thing is greatest in testimony? When they asked the Prophet ﷺ to bring the proof that he is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is the biggest, what is the greatest shahada? What is the greatest testimony to prove to them that the Prophet ﷺ is the final messenger of Allah? That to prove to them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. And that's the message of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Qulillah. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah. That means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best shaheed, is the best the best testimony comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the best of all witnesses. The best testimony is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, since He's the creator of all testimonies and He's the creator of all things. You can never find better evidences and better testimony than from the creator of the heavens and the earth Himself. And some said it's like when you say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is my witness. So when someone asks you for a proof of something, you would say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is my witness, that I am on the truth, that I'm saying the truth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that is witnessing for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is the highest level of testimony whatsoever, and that is by speech and actions, by speech which is mentioned in the Quran and in the revelation before, in the books before that was revealed to the prophets before, mentioning about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and with the actions, with the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that are explained in the Quran, and these universal signs and the proofs and evidences that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the final messenger of Allah, and the miracles that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aided the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with his mission. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best, and he's the greatest, and he is the all knower subhanahu wa ta'ala when it comes to matters of testimony. قُلِ اللَّهُ شَهِيدٌ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is shaheed, is witness between me and you, and he is the best of all witnesses subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the witness between anyone in any situation. And this is something that should bring the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hearts. When people get into transactions or contracts or promises or whatever situations that they're in, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that is witnessing what they're doing, no matter how many people, no matter how many different whether it's covenants or transactions or contracts or whatever there is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best of all witnesses. And that's why when people, they seek witnesses to make sure that their rights are preserved, when people have a contract or so, they have to have witnesses. Why? So that the rights are not lost, especially when people don't have truthfulness and so on. That's why people would make sure that everything is written and documented and so on. But they should also remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best of all witnesses, and he is witnessing what they're doing, whether it's marriage, whether it's buying and selling, in anything. If a person can deceive others and he can hide what he's not exposing to others, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all aware of it. That's why people should be fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they should be watchful in all of their speech and actions, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a witness between them and whoever they are in covenant with. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shaheedun bayni wa baynakum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the shaheed between you and myself. And this is something for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him to say, and also the same thing for the believers. وَأُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنُ لِأُنذِرَكُمْ بِهِ وَمَنْ بَلَغْ. That this Quran has been revealed to me. وَأُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنُ. The Quran has been revealed to me, that revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. For what reason? That I may warn you thereby and whomever it reaches. And this is the witness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants the people to see. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the greatest witness to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this final and living miracle, which is the Quran. That miracles goes away once it's done, and only those who witness it, they can relate to it. But those who come after them, they did not witness the miracle, so they don't really relate to the miracles, except the final message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran is the major and the most and the biggest and the greatest miracle to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that it's a living miracle till the day of judgment for every person to see for themselves and to witness the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes the one that witnessed for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he revealed to him this Quran. وَأُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ. And هذا here is to honor the book of Allah. That it has been revealed to me, this Quran, this beautiful book, this speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the life that without it, it's really death. Without it, it's darknesses. It's the light that lights the life of the believers. And if you can imagine life without the Quran, it's worthless. It has no value to it whatsoever. It's all darknesses. The life with the Quran is a beautiful one. When people believe in the Quran, when people act according to the Quran, and that's why this is the best gift that a person can have, is the book of Allah. It's the book of Allah, to recite it, to memorize it, to act according to it. And the more we have the knowledge of the Quran, the more all of the impurities and associating partners with Allah and the doubtful matters are removed from the hearts. And that's the greatest witness, that this is the greatest miracle, that the more the person learns the Quran, the more he becomes in state of tranquility with matters of iman, with matters of faith, opposite to falsehood. Many people, those who left their false religions, that happened when they learned about their false religions. The more they learned and they recited and they read their books, the more they saw clearly that this is not the truth. And opposite to those who are ignorant. When people are ignorant, they can follow any ignorant call. But when the matter is challenged in such a way, that learn it, examine it, reflect upon it. And the more you would learn it, the more that you would see that this is the truth. And that's the challenge of the Quran. And that's why it's incumbent upon us to learn the Book of Allah and to hold fast to it and to learn it and to reflect upon it. And the more we do that, the more our hearts will be purified. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لِأُنذِرَكُمْ بِهِ, to warn you by the Quran. So the Quran is a book of warning. Warning the disbelievers, warning those who do not hold fast to the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would afflict them if they turn away from the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِأُنذِرَكُمْ بِهِ وَمَنْ بَلَغْ, to warn you with the Quran and those who the Quran reaches them. وَمَنْ بَلَغْ, some people, they might take the message and they convey it to others. So everyone that the message of the Quran reaches them, then they should take this warning seriously, and that is to believe in the Book of Allah and to follow the Book of Allah, because the matter in it is very clear. And when things are very clear and a person doesn't take the clear signs and the warnings, then that person should not blame anyone but his own self when the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes to him. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَإِنَّكُمْ لَتَشْهَدُونَ أَنَّ مَعَ اللَّهِ أَلِهَةً أُخْرَى, that you would witness, talking to the disbelievers, you would witness that with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are other aliha, other gods to be worshipped. You witness, you believe that with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are other gods or deities that are to be worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether they believe that these deities create besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or provides or not, it doesn't matter. So the aliha are the things that are being worshipped. Idols, images, anything that is being worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if the disbelievers, they believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of all things, but they would worship other than Allah. They would fear other than Allah. They would rely on other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They would make dua and supplication to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to present that question to them, you witness, you testify, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with him are other deities to be worshipped besides him, whether it's prophets of Allah like Jesus the son of Mary or saints or whatever there is, then the clarity comes, قُلْ لَا أَشْهَدْ, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَا أَشْهَدْ, indeed I do not testify. I do not testify the same as you testify, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has deities, has things to be worshipped besides him. I do not witness to this. I deny this. I disbelieve in such disbelieving act here, and that is to believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has deities with him. See how clear the message of the Quran, no ambiguity in it whatsoever. قُلْ لَا أَشْهَدْ, I do not testify that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has deities besides him to be worshipped and so on. And then, what do you testify, O Prophet of Allah? What do you testify, the believers, those who followed the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? قُلْ إِنَّمَا هُوَ إِلَٰهٌ وَاحِدٌ وَإِنَّنِي بَرِيءٌ مِّمَّا تُشْرِكُونَ. قُلْ, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّمَا هُوَ إِلَٰهٌ وَاحِدٌ, indeed, he is only one إله. إِلَٰهٌ وَاحِدٌ, إِلَه, the one to be worshipped with perfect love and perfect submission, he's only one. Only one إله, one to be worshipped, and that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is not it, not enough. But then rather, وَإِنَّنِي بَرِيءٌ مِّمَّا تُشْرِكُونَ, and I distant myself from anything that you associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So two things that makes the testimony of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very clear, which is basically the meanings of لا إله إلا الله, to say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. The one to be worshipped is one. And when it comes to worship means salah, sujood, ruku'ah, fear, relying, hoping for the rewards, every act of worship, slaughtering, supplication, everything is only to be done to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّمَا هُوَ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ. One true ilah to be worshipped with perfect love and perfect submission. And the other fault to this is to distant oneself, to disbelief in anything that the disbelievers are worshipping or believing that is to be worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, this is both makes the meaning of La ilaha illallah, no one worthy of worship, disbelieving in anything that is being worshipped besides Allah, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the only one to be worshipped. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala with the rest of the verses after the break, so stay with us inshallah.
ألا يتدبرون القرآن؟
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Welcome back, and with the verses of Surah Al-An'am from verse number 17 to verse number 21 about the evidences of the Tawheed, the evidences of the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, that He's the only one worthy of worship. And if anybody asks for any testimony or any evidences, there is no one greater than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to testify that this is the truth by how He aided the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and this message, this Quran that was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that the one to be worshipped is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and to distant oneself away from anything that is being worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the meaning of the Tawheed that has two folds to it. One is to disbelieve in anything that is being worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to deny it, to make it clear that you don't testify to what they are doing of evil doing by worshipping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. Then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the next verse, which is verse number 20, about the people of the book. الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ فَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Those to whom we have given the scripture recognize it as they recognize their own sons. Those who will lose themselves in the hereafter do not believe. الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ. And they also witness to the truth, to the messengership of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the scripture, the people of the book, the knowledgeable among the Jews and the Christians, that those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the scripture, يَعْرِفُونَهُ, they recognize it as they recognize their own sons. They recognize this book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They recognize the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They recognize the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being the final messenger of Allah. كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ, the same way they know their sons. Nobody can have any confusion or ambiguity when it comes to one's sons. A person knows his son very well. He can pick his son and know his son in the midst of hundreds of people. So the same way they know their sons, the same way they know that this is the truth from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the messengership of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's mentioned in their books, the content of the message of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is the truth that the Prophet ﷺ brought to all mankind, and that is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So they know that very well. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exposes what's in the hearts of the people. So we know that for sure. The people of knowledge among them, if they deny, if they lie, we know that they know the truth. But why would they lie? Why would they deny? It's very simple, as this is one of the things that hinders human beings, or many of them, from the truth. To keep their status, to keep their honor among their people, not to follow the desires of this life, because it's a fact that those who would embrace the truth, then they are more likely to face more difficulties as a test for their faith, and people would oppose them. This is the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth. حَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا أَمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. Do people think that they will be left alone to say we believe and they won't be tested and they won't be tried? This is not the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth. That's why many people, they would leave the truth knowingly to choose the materialistic and the joy of this immediate life, which is so temporary, over the everlasting joy in the hereafter, which is of course a sign of foolishness and a sign of ignorance. But this is what happened. This is one of the reasons why some of them would turn away from the truth that they know more than they know their own sons. And this is something that has so many evidences at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as it happened to Hiraql, the king of the Romans, and as it happened to other people. And they know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the final messenger of Allah. Some of them they believed, like Abdullah ibn Salam, the chief of the Jews in Medina, one of their chiefs, and he believed in the truth, and he was one of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the story of his Islam is well known. And some others, they refused. They refused knowingly that they are refusing the truth. Why? To keep again the desire of this world. And we can relate to this. We know many times that a person would do something and he knowingly knowing that this is something wrong and it can bring the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and so on, and still the person do it. Right? So those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them the scripture, gave them the book before, يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ, they know that the Prophet ﷺ is the final messenger of Allah. They know about the Quran more than they know their own sons, that this is the truth from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ فَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ, those who lose themselves, meaning in the hereafter, do not believe. أَلَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ فَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ, how can a person lose himself? When a person lose himself in the hereafter, when a person make himself be among the people of the hellfire, that's the be loss. قُلْ إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَهْلِهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَمَةِ, that indeed those who the losers, the real losers, are those who lose their own selves and their families in the hereafter, in the day of judgment, when they would enter the hellfire. We're supposed to save ourselves, to save our lives, to save ourselves from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with al-Iman. So those who lose themselves are those who turn away from al-Iman. So al-Iman, faith, saves our life, save our everlasting joy. This Iman, this is the most valuable thing that we should seek. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us, to have this faith and the Iman in the heart and the tongue and the actions, and to be steadfast on matters of faith. Otherwise, a person loses himself, like some of these people from the people of the scripture. When the truth came to them, they know it more than they know their own sons, and they still denied it and turned away from it. They lost themselves when they removed al-Iman and faith from their hearts once they disbelieved in the Prophet ﷺ. And that's why those who believed in all of the prophets of Allah and they rejected the final message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are disbelievers. Nothing will benefit them. It won't benefit them that they believed in Musa alayhi salam or Jesus the son of Mary or any of the prophets of Allah. And the same thing if a Muslim, for example, believes in the messengership of the Prophet ﷺ, which is of course very rare to happen for someone to have a distorted belief in this, but then disbelief in one of the messengers of Allah that are mentioned in the Quran, for example, that person is a disbeliever. Why? Because he denied one of the messengers of Allah. So the people of the scripture, they know the Prophet ﷺ, the knowledgeable among them, they know the Prophet ﷺ more than they know their own sons. And those who lose themselves, those who have no faith, those who turn away from the faith. That the last verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا أَوْ كَذَّبَ بِآيَاتِهِ, وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا أَوْ كَذَّبَ بِآيَاتِهِ إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الظَّالِمُونَ. And who is more unjust than one who invents about Allah a lie or denies his verses? Indeed, the wrongdoers would not succeed. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ, that means who is more unjust, that means no one is more unjust than someone that would iftara ala Allahi kathiban, someone that would invent about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kathiban, which means a lie, aw kathaba bi ayati, or denies the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the verses, the signs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Waman azlam, that means there's no one more unjust than someone. What is this evil crime? افْتَرَى عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا, to invent a lie about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does it mean to invent a lie about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? To say something about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without knowledge. To say that this is a messenger of Allah or this is not a messenger of Allah based on one's desire. or for someone to invent a lie from Allah about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that it's permissible for them to associate partners with Allah, to rely on other than Allah, to fear other than Allah, to make sujood to other than Allah, to make dua to other than Allah, inventing lies about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inventing lies about Allah when it comes to the names and attributes of Allah, denying whatever they want to deny, altering the meanings of them, not believing in them in the proper way, inventing lies about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when people would have false beliefs, whatever that false beliefs might be, whether it matters of pillars of al-Iman or false beliefs about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, over exaggerating their belief and their praise to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, where they give the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam more divine attributes, for example. You know, this is all inventing lies about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, claiming that someone has the knowledge of the unseen without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like what is given to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of these distorted beliefs, these extremism in matters of belief, extremism in matters of actions, whether people inventing lies about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah would be pleased with them if they kill others, innocent people, for example, or they do evil actions. This is all inventing lies about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If people innovate in matters of their religion, innovating celebrations, specific celebrations, and they would relate this to the deen of Allah, inventing a certain act of worship or a specific salah or a specific dhikr, remembrance of Allah in a specific way that the Prophet ﷺ did not practice in that particular way. So it's a very detailed subject, and there's no one more unjust than someone that would invent a lie about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're supposed to be followers. We follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we are forbidden from inventing or liking things that is not revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to make it part of the religion. As false religions, they invented lies. Anything other than the truth is invented by the human beings. Human beings, they get together and they invent a lie. Many of the things that people follow cannot be attributed to the messengers of Allah. They are inventing lies, whether it's beliefs or actions and so on. And that's why every human being should be sincere enough to ask oneself a question. Am I praying like the Prophet ﷺ to the best of our ability? Others, when they pray, when they worship, are they truly with clear evidences they're following their messengers? And even though if they follow them, the final messenger is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where it's mandatory for everyone to follow the final messenger of Allah. So those who invent lies about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing is more unjust than them. أَوْ كَذَّبَ بِآيَاتِ, or to deny the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether it's the religious ayat, and these are the verses of the Quran, for example, to deny them that they are from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the universal ayat of Allah to attribute them to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So people, when they see the sun and the moon and the earth, and they see their own selves and the miraculous nature of the human beings, and they would attribute that to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or they would believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that created all of this, but they don't worship Him alone, but rather they worship themselves or they worship idols and so on. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says, إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الظَّالِمُونَ, that He would never make the ظالمون successful. The wrongdoers, the unjust ones, they would never be successful. So therefore, anything that we see on the face of earth, when the ظالمون, when the unjust people, they are prevailing or they're having anything on the face of earth, we should not call it success. This is actually, they are ruining themselves. And it's something temporary is given for them to increase their bad deeds and to test the believers, as we heard before. But the success, al-falah, is the one that never is removed from the person, that stays with him forever in this life, continuously to the hereafter. The success in this life is to fulfill its purpose. The success of this life is not to be the most wealthiest or the most person in status, but rather the success is to continue to be steadfast on the truth, to fulfill the purpose of this life. And the success is to enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be among the believers, to be among those who succeed in continuing the path of the truth. So whoever does not see the success in such a way, then he is losing himself. And that's why the real loss is when people lose their iman, lose their faith. So that's why إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الظَّالِمُونَ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not make the ظَالِمُونَ successful. We'll continue inshallah ta'ala with more verses and more benefits of Surah Al-An'am next time. So till next time, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
يتدبرون القرآن ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا
فلا يتدبرون القرآن ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا
لا يتدبرون القرآن
ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا
فلا يتدبرون القرآن ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيراً